Well, hey there, boys and girls, and I wanted to share part of our 2019 adventure in this short video. We're in Moab, Utah, at Arches National Park. We left Gunnison and did a 700-mile swing across the Colorado Plateau. To Moab, Utah, and then through Cortez, Colorado, and the Mesa Verde, which is a different slideshow. It was quite a ride. There were some time constraints, so I had to do a little planning, and which I usually don't do. Normally I just follow my nose and whatever happens, happens, but this made it a great run. We had great weather, although it's hot in Moab, but we dodged the storms, and it turned out that the entire 700-mile swing couldn't have been any better. Now we're coming along here on our way up into the national park. I believe we're going to pull over right here for a moment and to take a picture. Yeah, that's what we did. And there's the picture. So, back on the move again as soon as this traffic gets out of the way. And I believe it was just a little further up this road that we pulled over at another overlook to see some pinnacles. And best I remember, this is where we decided that the best way to see this place would be to go all the way to the end of the road and work our way back. That way we'd have a better idea of the places we wanted to see as we were coming back out of the park. This place is just massive. I've never been here, and I was quite impressed with it. You see that overlook coming up on the left, and we decided we'd walk out to the viewpoint from the parking lot. You can see a parking place coming up. Okay, fella, and you get out of the way and we can pull these two bikes in. Okay, with that, I put Anna in the lead. That's her up there. I need to put her in the lead more often. She doesn't seem to get as distracted or as lost as I do. But of course, I told her what to do, which was the wrong thing to do. I think she knew it. I told her that up here somewhere she had to make a left, and she did exactly what I said. And like an idiot, I kept the map on my windshield instead of giving it to her. But we'll come up here and make another turn, which was wrong. But she immediately pulls over and lets me figure out that I'm full of it. Seems I can't even stay on the right side of the road. But anyway, we'll stop here and have a little conversation and figure it all out. I'll pull up here and we'll see what happens.
it must be up there. That way's the arches. According to this. Let me look. Hang on. We're at the Garden of Eden. And that's the viewpoint for the Garden of Eden out the end of this road. And then stay on that road we were on, and you're get down to a double arch, turret arch, and some stuff like that.
Well, since we were here, we might as well ride on out here to the viewpoint for the Garden of Eden. But everything out here is just great. There are no bad viewpoints. And she'll find us a place to park out here, and we'll shut them down and walk around a little bit. Yeah, we made a couple of photographs. If that's not an Egyptian in the middle of that screen, I don't know what it is. There's some more of them. Really quite a place to see. This is the location of the fallen arch a little further down the road. They had this graphic that shows how they believe the arch was maybe 1,000 years ago or whatever. Now she's back in the lead without my instructions, so she'll find the end of the road here quite easily. As you can see, coming up to the left, you can see some arches. That's where we were headed. Had a heck of a time finding a parking place up here. And here's a shot of the San Juan Mountains in the background. Anna with the bikes. And I believe this next shot is a famous balance rock. It's silhouetted here. Got a shot of her in front of it, and another shot from the other edge, or the other side, where the sun was shining. And this video I had published earlier in Facebook, talking about how clean this place was. There are no trash cans at the overlooks and the pullouts, only at the restrooms, which there's very few of those. And as a result of that, this place is extremely clean. Not even a cigarette butt on the ground. Without trash cans, there's no litter. People just pack it out. So that works here. Anna says it's psychological, and I believe she's right. I believe I got a little bit out of sequence with this part, but that's okay. Photos of the arches will be coming up. Anyway, it gives me a chance to say that what I really enjoy on these rides is doing it with my kids. It's so much better. I've been a lot of places alone, and wait a minute, we got a gorilla coming up here. There's a gorilla. Faye Ray, she was quite a dish. Anyway, every time I'm in an interesting place by myself, I'm always thinking, boy, I wish my kids could see this or experience this. And although I've taken them all over the country as they were growing up, my older two have their families and they're busy with their lives. I've still got this one that I can run around with, and she certainly inherited the spirit of adventure. After this trip, she took off to Alaska. But I learn a lot, too, on these things since I've been videoing. You have behind the windshield is not a good place to video, and I've got the helmet cam on now, which is much better if I could just keep my head still. But I finally found a place to mount the camera on the left passing light on the bike. I can operate it with my hand. I don't like to operate it from the phone because that's a distraction. I have to take my eyes off the road, even though I have it mounted, have the phone mounted on my handlebars. Well, in this sequence, the arches will come up here in just a few seconds. In the first picture, you'll see Anna on the left, and she's marking up a workbook, which I'll explain a little later at the end of this video. Following that tour bus, I think we followed it two or three times. There we are at the arches. There she is working on her book, and she had to climb up there, of course, and look over the edge. I told her to get the hell off there. I didn't want her falling. Wind was really blowing. I believe that's turret arch back to our right. And here's a shot from where she was standing, looking over the valley. I'll leave that one to your imagination. This is a lot of caves and places like that that pretty interesting. This is the famous double arch. It's quite an impressive place. Another shot of the San Juan Mountains in the background. There's the freestanding arch that's been photographed so many times back over there. And here we go again. Now to the right of that pinnacle, if that's not an Egyptian standing there, I don't know what is. But we go to these places, and they've always given me such a sense of how important they are and how much we need to save places like this. It's not just for us, but for future generations, and they need to be protected. Another shot of the San Juans. I was very interested in that because we were headed there the next day. Well, I said I would explain the book. When we first got to the visitor center, we went inside, and Anna discovered that they had a junior ranger program. And when she was at Mount St. Helens, she was in charge of the junior ranger program. So she walks up to the ranger and says she wants the book and wants to be a junior ranger. And they looked at her and thought, well, actually they said to her, aren't you a little old for a junior ranger program? Well, she didn't tell them anything. She just got the book. So as we toured the park, she would go to each page and fill out whatever it was that needed to be filled out in the Junior Ranger book. So we're headed back out now, and headed back down to the visitor center. This road is the only part of the park that has any steep drop-offs, and the roads are great, by the way. Just had to throw that in there. But this is the same sequence that in the beginning where I was filming through the windshield. Anyway, with her junior ranger workbook filled out and headed back to the visitor center, of course we stopped there for go to the restroom, get a little water, and she could turn her book in. So she takes it back up to the ranger station and says, okay, here it is. I want my badge. And still without telling them anything, of course, they had to give her a junior ranger badge. I guess they thought she was an 11-year-old that was just really tall. That's the visitor center coming up on the left. And it was a great day, quite a ride. So we'll pull in here for a little bit and before we head on back to our suite. And there she is with her junior ranger badge. Catch y'all next time.